So I welcome you all to the new session of the Fourier Integral Transforms. And today we shall be discussing about the Fourier transform and the inverse Fourier transform. Fourier transform is similar to the Laplace transforms. Here we have already discussed that the kernel is different. In that Laplace transform, the kernel was e to the power minus st. But here in the Fourier transform, if we take the Fourier complex transforms, the kernel is here is e to the power iota st. And the limits are from minus infinity to infinity. You can see that the limits are from minus infinity to infinity. The function is multiplied with the kernel. The kernel here is e to the power iota st. So the integration is carried over the t variable. If you want to express it in x, you can express it in x also. So it is minus infinity to infinity ft e to the power iota st into dt. And there is a constant factor outside the integral, that is 1 by root 2 pi. So if you calculate the Fourier transform on the function that is represented by f of fx, which is also denoted by capital Fs, because when we shall solve this integration, what will happen? You will get a result in the s equation. So there will be the equation in s variable, that is y of s. Every time, whenever you see, if you perform the Laplace transform or Fourier transform, Fourier sine transform, every time you are getting your answer in the s variable, that is why it is expressed as f of s. And if we take the inversion formula that we want to calculate our f of x, so the Fourier is taken here, we have to apply the Fourier inverse function. So the Fourier, when you apply the Fourier inverse, it is something represented like this form, that your f of x is now 1 upon 2 under root 2 pi. Again, integration has the same limits from minus infinity to infinity. F of s, the kernel here is now e to the power minus iota sx into ds. Now the integration is carried over the s variable. You take the one to calculate the f of x. So f of x is 1 by root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to infinity f of s e to the power minus iota sx into ds. So this is the basic definition of your Fourier transform. So again, I am repeating it. So whenever you carry the Fourier transform on the function f of x, it is represented by f of fx, which is also called as f of s, which is 1 by root 2 pi integration from minus infinity to infinity f of t. It is multiplied with the kernel e to the power iota st into dt. Since when you carry this integration over the t variable and you substitute the limits for minus infinity and plus infinity, your answer will be in the s variable. That is why we are writing it as f of s. So our inversion formula is that we calculate the function f of x, which is 1 by root 2 pi integration minus infinity to infinity f of s. The kernel here is e to the power minus iota sx into ds. Now the integration is carried over the s variable and we get the answer in our x variable or t variable, whichever variable is desired. So that is the answer. So this is called the Fourier inversion formula. Inversion means we are calculating the function itself. So let's see the proof of the Fourier transform. So here we have that we have already derived the Fourier complex formula. So we had the Fourier complex integral formula was that f of x is 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity e to the power minus iota ux du integral minus infinity to infinity ft to the power iota ut dt. So we had already this formula. Now what we do, we split our 1 upon 2 pi factor into two parts. So here we have 1 by root 2 pi associated with one integral and another 1 by root 2 pi associated with the second integral. We have replaced our u with s. So the equation comes as 1 by root 2 pi minus infinity to infinity e to the power minus iota sx ds into 1 by root 2 pi माइनस इनफिनिटी टू इनफिनिटी एफ टी टू द पावर आयोटा एस टी डी टी. सो वॉट इज नाउ सेड दैट दिस फंक्शन दिस पार्ट ऑफ द फंक्शन द सेकेंड इंटेग्रल. The second integral is represented by f of s. This portion is represented by f of s. You can see here that this is your f of s. So this f of s is called the Fourier transform of f of x. So what you get, the function f of x will be now represented by 1 by root 2 pi minus infinity to infinity to the power minus iota sx fs into ds. So in this way, from one equation, you get both the results of the inverse Fourier transform as well as for the Fourier transform. So the Fourier transform f of s is 1 by root 2 pi integration minus infinity to infinity ft to the power iota st dt, and the inverse Fourier transform, which is the function itself, that is f of x, is 1 by root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity to the power minus iota sx fs ds. So we have the question that we have to find the Fourier transform of f of x. The function is given by that x square. It is x square when modulus x is less than a, and it is 0 when modulus x is greater than a. So if we see the solution, I have expressed our modulus x less than a. So modulus x less than a can be represented as x is lying between the interval minus a to a. Can write it as, for the modulus of x greater than a, it can be written as, you can see here that modulus x is greater than a. So modulus x greater than a means for positive value of x, it is x greater than a. And minus x is also greater than a means that you can take the negative sign to the other side, so the signs are also replaced, so greater than becomes less than. So you get x is less than minus a. So if we plot the number line, what you see that this is zero value, this is minus a value, and this is plus a value. So for the x lying between minus a to a, the value will be x square. It is taking the value of x square. But when it is having a value x greater than a, or it is having a value less than minus a, each time the value of the x, function of x, is zero. So this is the equation that is given to you for the f of x. So we have this equation. So now we have to find the Fourier transform. You can see the question is to find the Fourier transform. So what we do, we apply the formula of the Fourier transform. So we have just studied now that the Fourier transform is represented by f of s, which is represented by 1 by root of 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity ft to the power iota st dt. So for the value of this f of t, you have to take the value of f of t from the function itself, and your x will be now substituted by t. So the value of f of t is t square, where it is lying from minus a to a, and for all other values the function is having a value of zero. So what happens, that the integral which is having the limit of minus infinity to infinity is now changed to minus a to a. You have the limits now from minus a to a. Ft is written as t square, e to the power iota st dt is from the formula itself. So you get the, for minus infinity to infinity ft, you get it as minus a to a into t square e to the power iota st dt. Now the question is just to solve the integration. You can see here that the integration involves two functions of t. So it is type of UV function. So we have to integrate our question by using the integration by parts. So we shall be using this formula, that integral of UV is U as it is, in first integration of V minus first derivative of u into second integral of v plus second order derivative of u and third integral of v. So we get this as 1 by root 2 pi. So our t square is u and e to the power iota st is v. So t square as it is, e to the power iota st ka integral is e to the power iota st upon iota s. Then the negative sign, first derivative of t square is 2t, and the second integral or double integration of e to the power iota st will be e to the power iota st by iota s ka whole square. Then positive sign, and the derivative of 2t is 2. Then we have the triple integral of e to the power iota st, which is e to the power iota st upon iota s raised to power cube, and we have to apply the limits from minus a to plus a. So since the variable on which the integration was there was on the t variable, so we shall be substituting the limits of a and minus a in the t variable. So first putting the upper limit, you get this part, and then you substitute the lower limit, so you get these three parts. We are solving the equation. Now we collect the terms of a square by s. So collecting the terms of a square by s, we get this is as e to the power iota sa minus e to the power minus iota sa upon iota into, we multiply by 2 and 2. Why? Because then what will be there, that we can substitute a formula for this. You know that e to the power iota theta minus e to the power minus iota theta by 2 iota is nothing but sine of theta. So we have the coefficient of a square by s as e to the power iota sa minus e to the power minus iota sa by iota, and we have multiplied by 2 and 2 divided by 2. Similarly, we collected the coefficient of 2a by s square, and we have the coefficient as e to the power iota sa plus e to the power minus iota sa. Again, we have multiplied and divided by 2. We collected the coefficient of 2 by s cube, and we get the value as e to the power iota sa minus e to the power minus iota sa upon iota, and again we have multiplied and divided by 2. Now we know that this e to the power iota theta minus e to the power iota theta upon 2 iota is sine of theta. So we can write for this term as sine of sa. And there is a positive sign here, so it is e to the power iota theta plus e to the power minus iota theta upon 2. So for that term, we can write it as cos theta. So it is cos of SA. And again here, the same rule has been applied, and we get it, the result as sine of SA. So since there are two terms of sine SA, so we can write it as sine SA into 2a square by s minus 4 by s cube, and plus 4a by s square cos of sa into 1 by root 2 pi. So this is our result, this is our answer. So in this way, we are able to solve the Fourier transform of the given function. So we one note point that some of the authors might be using the notation that there is no 1 by root 2 pi with the f of x, and there is in f of s, it is written as 1 by 2 pi, because when we are doing our proof of this Fourier transform, we had split our 1 by 2 pi as 1 by root 2 pi in two parts. So in some of the authors might be using that this 1 by 2 pi is kept with one of the integral, and there is no factor associated with the other integral. So in the question or in the results of the Fourier transform, the function might be written as minus infinity to infinity e to the power minus iota sx fs ds. And with the Fourier transform, it is written as 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to infinity ft to the power iota st. Or it could be written in the other way also, that this f of s is not having any of this constant term, but the f of x is having a term of this, what is called as 1 upon 2 pi. So there will be a term of 1 upon 2 pi with this f of x, not 1 by root 2 pi. It would be 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity to the power minus iota sx fs ds. And the fs would be minus infinity to infinity ft to the power iota st dt. So there is an always argument that to with what we should associate this 1 by 2 pi factor. So from my point of view, it would be better that we split our 1 by 2 pi in with both the integrals, and we associate this 1 by root 2 pi with both the Fourier transform as well as with the inverse Fourier transforms. So whenever you solve the question, whenever you are solving your numericals, don't bother about this constant term. You put your formula and you solve it accordingly. Let's take a look at the second question. So we have here that we have to show that the Fourier transform of this function, the function is f of x is a minus of mod x. Here we have that it is a minus of mod x, where mod x is lying between, or mod x is less than a, which means that x is lying between minus a to plus a, and the function is zero for mod x greater than a, and a is also greater than zero. Means that for every x greater than a or x is less than minus of a, then the value of the function is zero. So we have to prove here that if we carry the Fourier transform of our function f of x, so the answer will be root 2 by pi 1 minus cos as upon s square. And hence we have to deduce that 0 to infinity sin t by t square sine of t by 2 into dt is pi by 2. Okay, so we have to show this result. We have to prove it. So let us see the solution of this question. So first of all, we have to apply the Fourier transform. So the first thing what we will do, we will apply the formula of the Fourier transform. So the Fourier transform is written as f of s, which is 1 by root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity fx e ki power iota sx dx. So you can see from the question that this x, mod x is less than a, means this x is lying between minus a to a. And when this x is lying between minus a to a, this means that, what you mean this? That when, if we draw a number line, you can see here, if we draw a number line, we have that this value is 0, this is a, and this is minus a. So when the x value is lying between 0 to a, it will have positive value of x. And when it is lying in the negative side here, so it will have a negative value of x. So now our integral from minus a to a also, it will be broken up into two parts. You can see here, I have broken my integral of minus a to a in two parts. So when it is from minus a to 0, when it is from minus a to 0, for this x value, I have to write it here as minus of x. So it will be written as a minus of minus x e ki power iota sx dx. And for the interval between 0 to a, my x will take the positive value. So it will have a minus of x e to the power iota sx into dx. So again, I am repeating this part. My integral was from minus infinity to infinity fx e to the power iota sx dx. Now, since for the values x greater than a or x less than minus a, my values is 0. So the limits are now my from minus a to a. But since in the question I have a minus of modulus x, this means that when on my number line I have on the positive side from 0 to a, my x values will be all positive. But from the number line from 0 to minus a, my x values will take a negative values. So I have broken my integral into two parts. So my integral is from minus a to 0. So from minus a to 0, my x is taking the negative value. So it is minus x. And for 0 to a, my x will take the positive value. So it is positive x, and it will take a minus of x e ki power iota sx dx. So this is the basic step that has to be remembered. If you directly put it as a minus of x, so your answer will be different. It will not come as the right answer, because we have to consider this modulus x also. This modulus x is not simple x. So its values is changing according to the number line. So we have to substitute the values of x according to the limits. So from minus a to 0, the function becomes a plus x e ki power iota sx dx. And for 0 to a, the function becomes a minus of x e ki power iota sx into dx. Now, afterwards, it is simple integration. Integration has to be carried on. So you can write this as a e to the power e ki power iota sx upon iota s. Now for the x e ki power iota sx, you have carried on the UV chain rule, which is the integration by parts. So you get x e ki power iota sx upon iota s minus e ki power iota sx upon iota s ka whole square. And we have to apply the limits from minus a to 0. For the second integral of a minus of x e to the power iota x, again we can write it as a times e to the power iota sx upon iota s minus of x e to the power iota sx upon iota s minus of e to the power iota sx upon iota s ka whole square. And the limits to be applied for the second integral are from 0 to a. Now, since the integral is carried over the x variable, so you have to substitute the value of a in the x variable. So wherever there is x, we substitute the limits. So here we get a e raised to power 0 upon iota s, and we know that anything raised to power 0 is 1. So for e to power 0, we shall substitute the value of 1. Here it is x multiplied, so 0 multiplied by something is 0. In the last term, we get again e to the power 0 upon iota square s square. Then we put the lower limit, so we get a times e to power minus iota sa upon iota s, then a e to the power minus iota sa upon iota s plus e to power iota sa upon iota square s square. Then again we have e to power iota sa into a upon iota s minus a times e to power iota sa upon iota s plus e to power iota sa upon iota square s square minus e to the power 0 a upon iota s. We have 0, and the last term is e to the power 0 upon iota square s square. So you can see that these two parts gets cancelled out, and many other parts are also getting cancelled. So we get the remaining as a upon iota s plus 1 by s square minus e to the power minus iota sa upon s square minus of e to the power iota sa upon s square minus a upon iota s plus 1 by s square. So 1 by s square, 1 by s square, and there are two terms, so we get 2 by s square minus, again you can see this, that a by iota s and this a by iota s gets cancelled. So you get minus sign is taken out common, you get e to the power iota sa plus e to the power minus iota sa upon s square. So you can multiply it by 2 and divide it by 2, and here you can write it as 2 cos of sa. So we have written as 2 minus of 2 cos sa upon s square. So 2 is taken out common. So 2 divided by root 2 is root 2 in the numerator. So you get root 2 by pi 1 minus of cos sa, or can be written as 1 minus cos as upon s square. So this is the result that was to be proved, and we are proved the Fourier transform of fx to be root 2 by pi 1 minus of cos as upon s square. We have to prove, or we have to show, that 0 to infinity sine t by t square into sine of t by 2 dt is equal to pi by 2. So we have already derived the Fourier transform of this integral. So when we want to calculate, now we have to show this another integral. So another integral we have to prove in the Fourier transform means that it is asking you to derive the inversion formula. So always remember that if in the question it is that you have to first solve the Fourier transform and then you have to derive that a certain integral is equal to certain value, then it is demanding that you have to now apply the inverse Fourier transform function formula. So we know that the inversion formula is f of x is 1 by root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity f of s e to the power minus iota sx ds. So we have this inversion formula, and we have derived the value of f of s to be as minus of, sorry, plus root 2 by pi 1 minus cos of sa upon s square. So we shall be using this result to prove the equation which has to be proved here. So we shall be substituting the result of f of s now. F of x. So f of x is 1 by root 2 pi minus infinity to infinity f of s e to the power minus iota sx dx. So substituting the value of f of s, so we get 1 by root 2 pi integration minus infinity to infinity root 2 by pi 1 minus cos sa upon s square into the kernel here is now e to the power minus iota sx, and the integration is now performed over the s variable. First, the integration was solved over the x variable. Now, the integration is solved over the s variable. This integration values or variables has to be taken into great care. So we get as 1 by root 2 pi integration minus infinity to infinity root 2 by pi 1 minus of cos as upon s square into e to the power minus iota sx into ds. So now I expand my e to the power iota theta as cos theta plus iota theta. And if it is e to the power minus iota theta, it can be written as cos theta minus iota sine theta. So my theta is now s of x. You can see here, this is my theta. So what it is written as cos sx minus iota sine of sx into ds. So I have expanded my e to the power minus iota sx as cos sx minus iota sine of sx. Now, since there is a limit from minus infinity to infinity, and we have this result that if our function f of x is going to be integrated and the limits are from minus a to a, the values are same, but just the sign is getting inverted, then it will have a zero value if the function is odd. And if the function is even, then it is 2 times the zero, integral 0 to a fx dx. If the function is even. So we shall use this property to solve the integral. So what will happen now when you solve it, you can see this, your one integral will be associated with this cos term. So you know that your one is an even function, cos term is even function, cos of sx is even function, and s square is also even. So all are even. So even can be written as 2 times of 1 minus cos sx dx upon s square, and the limits are now from 0 to infinity. But when you multiply this whole term of cos of sa with sine of sx, so this cos one term is even, cos of sx is even, but when you multiply it with sine term, when this equation or this bracketed term is multiplied with sine term, but the sine term is an odd term. So even into odd term will be an odd term. So using this property that minus a to a fx dx is zero for the odd function, so we are left out with just one term of the factor of 2 times 0 to infinity 1 minus cos a cos of sx dx upon s square. So for this sine term, the integral factor is equal to 0 because our term will be an odd function. So for the cos term, the function is an even function. So we have written it as 2 times 0 to infinity 1 minus cos a into cos sx into ds upon s square. So this is our f of x now. Now if we compare the results, if we compare these two equations, okay? If we compare these two equations, there is no s here. So what is here now? There is a t variable. You can see there is a t variable. So we have make a substitution that let s is equal to t. And since another term that is involved, that is with t, there is a half variable also. So for x value, we are substituting it to be as a by 2 because our a was x was lying between the intervals of minus a to a. So we have taken that a x is equal to a by 2 and we find the value of f of a by 2. So f of a by 2 means a is in the positive part of the number line. So x will take the positive value. So x is equal to a by 2 here. So x will be a by 2. So a minus a by 2 will be a by 2. So I have written here that f of a by 2, which is a minus of a by 2, is a by 2. So we substitute the value of f of x, which is a by 2. So it is a by 2 into 2 by pi into 0 to infinity in integral 2 upon t square, because now s is replaced by t. So in the denominator also you are having s square. So it is 2 by t square sine square a t by 2. 1 minus of cos of sa can be represented by sine square a t by 2 into cos of t. For x we have substituted a by 2. So it is a by 2 into dt. Since s is equal to t, so ds is equal to dt. So you know that if you club 2 sine a cos b, sorry, 2 sine a cos a, it is sine of 2a. So we write it as this pi by 2 is 0 to infinity integral sine t upon t square into sine of t by 2 into dt. So this was our result, and we have also substituted that the value of a is equal to 1, because in the question there is no a and the value of a is taken to be equal to 1. So in this way we are able to solve our question. So just see what the question is demanding, and accordingly you have to apply the inverse Fourier transform formula and to make these substitutions by seeing the question itself. So the substitutions were that first substitution you made, that you substituted that s is equal to t, and then you have to put the value of f of x, and you are seeing that there is a half factor there. So we put that, let us x is equal to a by 2. So s is equal to a by 2, and then after we don't require any a, so we have make a substitution that let a is equal to 1. So by using these results we can prove the result. So the next question is that you have to find the Fourier transform of 1 by modulus x. So again I have taken a question of the mod x now again. So you can see here that the function is given to be 1 by mod x, but no interval is given that this x is lying between so and so and it is this. So now we have this Fourier transform function. So the Fourier transform function's formula is 1 by root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity f of x e ki power iota sx into dx. Now since we have modulus of x in the denominator, so this means that we have a number line that if the value of x is greater than 0, it will take a positive value, and if it is on the negative side of the number line, so it will take a negative value. So we will now substitute the value of modulus x according to the limits. So we have now broken our integrals into two parts. So first integral is from minus infinity to 0, and the second integral is from 0 to infinity. So one of my integral is now from minus infinity to 0, and the second integral is from 0 to infinity. So for minus infinity to 0, we know that on the number line from minus infinity to 0, the x value will take a negative value. So we have substituted minus of x for minus infinity to 0. But for 0 to infinity, this modulus x will take a positive value. So we have taken a positive x in the under root. So we have the equation as 1 by root of minus x e ki power iota sx dx plus integral 0 to infinity 1 by root x e ki power iota sx dx. So it is 1 by root of 2 pi. For under root of minus 1, we can write it as iota. So I have written here as minus infinity to 0 1 by iota root x e ki power iota sx dx plus 0 to infinity 1 by root x e ki power iota sx into dx. So this, if this iota is taken to the numerator, what you get a minus iota. So this minus sign can be accommodated with the limits of the integral by interchanging the limits. So I have interchanged the limit and I have written it as 0 to infinity iota e ki power minus, sorry, iota times e ki power iota sx upon root x dx. And the second integral is as it is, that is 0 to infinity e ki power iota sx upon root x dx. Now you can see that this 0 to infinity e ki power iota sx upon under root x into dx is common in both the terms. So we have this 1 by iota common, because it is a constant term we have taken out, and we have now to integrate over the integral e ki power iota sx upon root x dx. So now I make a substitution that let my iota sx is equal to minus of y square. I make this substitution. So if my iota sx is minus of y square, then what will happen? That if I take the root on both the sides, it will be under root of iota sx will be root of minus y square. So it will be iota into y, because under root minus 1 is iota, it will be iota y. So my under root x will be written as iota y by root of iota s. And if I differentiate this equation, what will I get? I will get that iota s dx is equal to minus 2y dy. और dx is equal to minus 2y by iota s into distribution. So I get my f of s is 1 by root 2 pi 1 plus iota integral for e to the power iota sx is e ki power minus y square upon iota y upon under root iota s into minus 2y by iota s into dy. So there is just simple calculations. We calculated and in the integral we are left out with the term of e to the power minus y square dy, because here this y and this y gets cancelled. So my y gets cancelled. I am left out with the integral of integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus y square dy. So there is this result that integral of 0 to infinity e to the power minus y square dy is root pi by 2. So using this result, you can directly substitute the value of this integral. You have to remember this result. This is a very important result, that integral of 0 to infinity e to the power minus y square dy is root pi by 2. So directly using this result, we substitute the value and we get the equation as, we get the value of the Fourier transform to be 1 plus iota into root iota upon 2 under root 2s. So this is the Fourier transform of 1 by root and modulus x. So thank you and meet you again. Thank you.